Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Saturday, the presentation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Hail, Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King who rules heaven and earth forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. As we venerate the glorious memory of the Most Holy Virgin Mary, grant we pray, O Lord, through her intercession, that we too may merit to receive from the fullness of your grace, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice from heaven speak to me. Here are my two witnesses. These are the two olive trees and the two lampstands that stand before the Lord of the earth. If anyone wants to harm them, fire comes out of their mouths and devours their enemies. In this way, anyone wanting to harm them is sure to be slain. They have the power to close up the sky so that no rain can fall during the time of their prophesying. They also have power to turn water into blood and to afflict the earth with any plague as often as they wish. When they have finished their testimony, the beast that comes up from the abyss will wage war against them and conquer them and kill them. Their corpses will lie in the main street of the great city, which has the symbolic names Sodom and Egypt, where indeed their Lord was crucified. Those from every people, tribe, tongue, and nation will gaze on their corpses for 3.5 days, and they will not allow their corpses to be buried. The inhabitants of the earth will gloat over them and be glad and exchange gifts because these two prophets tormented the inhabitants of the earth. But after the 3.5 days, a breath of life from God entered them. When they stood on their feet, great fear fell on those who saw them. Then they heard a loud voice from heaven say to them, "Come up here." So they went up to heaven in a cloud as their enemies looked on. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "Blessed be the Lord, my rock."
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for battle, my fingers for war.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
My mercy and my fortress, my stronghold, my deliverer, my shield, in whom I trust, who subdues my people under me.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
O God, I will sing a new song to you. With a 10-string lyre, I will chant your praise. You who give victory to kings and deliver David, your servant, from the evil sword.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock. Alleluia, alleluia. Our Savior Jesus Christ has destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
While he was still speaking to the crowds, his mother and his brothers appeared outside, wishing to speak with him. Someone told him, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside asking to speak with you." But he said in reply to the one who told him, "Who is my mother? who are my brothers? And stretching out his hand toward his disciple, he said, Here are my mother and my brothers, for whoever does the will of my heavenly Father is my brother and sister and mother. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we celebrate today the one of the feasts of our Blessed Mother, the Feast of the Presentation, I just want to invite you to reflect on Mary's own faith, no, her in a sense her own faith journey. Number one is that, you know, we always see our Blessed Mother as someone who is constantly discerning. As I mentioned time and again in our masses, lagi nating nakikita, di ba, sa Ebanghelyo, pag meron nangyari sa Panginoon, sa kanyang anak, yung makikita mong linya sa Ebanghelyo at pinagnilayan niyan lahat ng mga bagay nito sa kanyang puso. She kept all of these things in her heart. She reflected on these things in her heart. And I think that is the first point that, you know, we ask from our Blessed Mother to have a discerning heart, just like her. Because very often, no, she did not completely understand, no, what was going on in the life of her son. But she just kept all these things in her heart. And I think that was the discerning of the meaning of the events in her son's life. No? And we can pray for that grace, especially given what is going on all around us, what is happening with the pandemic, and then most recently the calamities, many, many people suffering. I think it's very good to have a discerning heart. And the second point that I invite you to reflect on is that in the Gospel it says here, whoever does the will of my Heavenly Father is brother and sister and mother to me. That is what the Lord says. No? And I think precisely it is through discerning the events and the things going on all around us and the events in our life that we are able to discover what it is that God wants us to do. And of course, again, our Blessed Mother is an example of discovering what God wants her to do. During that narrative of the mystery of the Incarnation, the Annunciation, you have her, Mary, pictured as a very prayerful person. As a very prayerful person who, when the time came for the Lord to reveal His mission for her, again, you see her discerning, asking the angel, how can this be since I do not know man? And that was a questioning, as many spiritual writers and even theologians would say, it was a questioning within faith. It was not a doubting within faith, but a questioning within faith. And there, through her questioning, she's able to know very clearly what was her mission, what was God's will for her. And I think that is also something that we ask for, no? That we be able to truly know God's will and God's mission for us, what God wants us to do. And I think more important, really, after knowing, is the doing, the obedience, no? To hear and to obey, to hear and to put into action. And most certainly from the moment that it became clear to her what her mission was, she dedicated her life totally to that mission. Just completely giving of herself to the mission to become the mother of the Savior. And I think that is the second grace that we pray for through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, to be able to truly dedicate ourselves to the mission that God wants us to do in total obedience, in the same way that she was very obedient to God's will. And then the third and final point is that one of my favorite, well, aside from the Magnificat, no, but the Magnificat is an entirely a homily that deserves a homily all by itself. No, but the third point that I always like with the Blessed Mother is whenever in John, the miracle at the wedding of Cana, in the Gospel of John, wherein the Blessed Mother, despite being rejected, tells everybody else, do whatever He tells you. And I think that is the third gift that we can pray for, that no matter what happens in our life, no matter how sometimes seemingly setbacks come our way, what the Blessed Mother says, do whatever her son tells you. Siguro yun yung tatlong punto lang na pagnilayan natin ngayon sa kapistahan ng Mahal na Birhen, the presentation of Mary. Number one, to constantly ask the Lord. Bigyan tayo ng ano, bigyan tayo ng Panginoon ng biyaya ng pangingilatis, yung discernment na sinasabi natin na ginawa ng Mahal na Birhen, na pakilatisin lahat ng nangyayari sa ating buhay. At dahil nga dito sa pangingilatis na ito, ay upang malaman natin kung ano ang misyon ng Diyos sa atin, kung anong gustong pagawa sa atin ng Diyos. At sa panahon na malaman natin ay maging mapagtalima sa kagustuhan ng Diyos. So yung dalawa, pangangilatis, mapagtalima o obedience. At yung pangatlo ay yung Mahal na Birhen na laging nagsasabi sa atin, kahit ano man ang mangyari sa ating buhay, lagi tayong bumaling sa Panginoon at gawin ko ano ang sinasabi sa atin ng Panginoong Hesukristo. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Today, as we commemorate the presentation of the Blessed Virgin Mary, let us ask the Father to grant us the generosity of heart in consecrating our life to God. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may offer as a fitting offering to God the services of men and women, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who believe in Christ may listen to the voice of God who calls each one to be holy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the example of Mary may shine through the life of consecrated persons, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ's presence may be felt by the sick and those who suffer through our comforting presence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may offer a worthy sacrifice through our righteous life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us again now offer our prayers. And we remember all the souls of the faithful departed, commended to our prayers and remembered as intentions in these masses. So let us now offer our prayer for the faithful departed.
Prayer for the faithful departed. This month of All Souls, we remember all our family and friends who have gone ahead of us. We pray for all the souls in purgatory. Grant them, Father, eternal rest together with you, our risen Lord, the Spirit of Life, our Blessed Mother, and all the saints. May we always remember them in our prayers. We ask that they too pray for us, all our family and friends who continue our journey here on earth. Amen.
With the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints. Especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. And truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially all the souls of the faithful departed, commended to our prayers, and remember at every Mass at ABS-CBN. We remember too our brothers and sisters from our families and friends who have gone ahead of us. Let us now pause for a moment and remember our departed relatives and friends. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day, In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray, Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Again, we'd like to invite you, starting this afternoon after the first Sunday Mass, anticipated Mass, and then tomorrow after every Kapamilya Sunday Mass, Journeys of Hope, and this afternoon and tomorrow is a special. We're featuring the group Actor, and the ones who will represent them is, aside from Isa Calzado, Ria Ataide also joined the conversation. So please join us, because I think it's a very good episode to understand their commitment to help in the recovery in the recent calamities, but also in terms of building up our country as members of the entertainment industry. So please join us for Journeys of Hope this weekend after every Kapamilya Sunday Mass. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
And also, tomorrow, Sunday, at 3 p.m., we'll have another rosary. Please join us via the ABS-CBN Facebook page and also One Palm PH, since tomorrow is the Feast of Christ the King.